Hello, it's Attorney Bose. A binocular video. One of the persons who happens to be watching my channel asked a question about nighttime use of binoculars or low light use of binoculars. No matter what you try to do, in my view, there is some value to having one unit that you use exclusively for nighttime duty or low light duty. It helps if you have a unit that can do double duty, but most of the time, if you want to have a small, tidy unit, particularly a pocket binocular unit, you're not going to get the same capability in low light or nighttime use. As I have stated in other videos, my nighttime preferred unit are these Fujinons, 7x50s. This one has been modded a bit for surveillance use, and it is a fairly lightweight unit. There are some other videos that I've done exclusively talking about the specifics of this particular Fujinon unit. And the reason that I like it is because it's relatively inexpensive, about $200 on Amazon currently. And it's a no-frills model that has the individual focus system. To those of you that are uncertain as to whether you should purchase individual focus, in which you are focusing without any type of center knob, you're focusing the individual eyepieces to your individual pupil, and then using this unit without the need for focusing, usually 20 meters and beyond to infinity. The idea of nighttime use of individual focus binoculars appeals to me. And the reason that it does is because in the middle of the night, I generally, if I'm observing a static target, not a moving target, a static target, it is very difficult to resolve and focus onto that static target. And it's better for me to not have to fiddle with the center focus at all during nighttime use. Plus, as I've stated in another video, for adverse conditions, when it's raining or otherwise, the last thing that you want to do is sit there fiddling with the center focus when your target is in front of you and you need to make the observation. So for these reasons, I prefer, particularly for nighttime usage, individual focus systems. Now, this Fujinon I love because it's got everything that I need and it's been modded slightly for me. For instance, this Fujinon has a polycarbonate body. And as you know, with polycarbonate bodies, when you use it in the cold weather, the polycarbonate is cold. And your fingers and hand, although they have a good purchase on the unit with these, with this real estate that's available to you, I often find that it's become slippery and it's just not as user-friendly as some of the armored units, such as by Steiner. I am a huge fan of the nighttime units by Steiner, whether they be the Night Hunter or otherwise, but with the Night Hunter, with a 8x56 configuration, you're looking at $1,000, $1,200, right? For a much more beater-worthy unit that you are tossing in the back of your Jeep, tossing in the back of your truck, and otherwise you would rather have something that you didn't spend too much money on that can be replaced without breaking the bank. And these Fujinons fit the bill. What I've done is to just place a little bit of hockey tape onto the body of the unit, and that gives me a very nice purchase, which is relatively free from the cold and the slipperiness that you get with a polycarbonate without such a coating of hockey tape on it. I said coating, it's actually the wrapping of the hockey tape on it. And with this, as it stands right now, it's not the prettiest thing, but it gets the job done. And 7x50 is what this binocular is. 7x magnification, 50 millimeter objective lens. That is beautiful for nighttime usage. Is the 8 magnification with a 56 millimeter objective lens, such as on the Steiner Night Hunter, more capable during the nighttime? Absolutely. And the coatings that those Steiners have are obviously going to be better, but there is a premium that you will be paying. And to those of us that use binoculars for surveillance work or other specialized activities, the last thing that we want is for the purchasing of a very expensive unit that may either get lost, picked up by one of our colleagues, and or destroyed when we're using them out in the field. $200 is much more palatable. So there you have it. My view on nighttime binoculars and which unit is my favorite, the Fujinon 7x50s, or my thoughts on what I use for my work when I have any type of surveillance that I am doing. So let's just get a close up of what we've got here. Very simple unit. You folks take care.